Hey yo, what is up guys? Welcome back to the channel. We are definitely glad to have you guys here with us today after some awesome feedback here that we got from you guys on some of our last videos. We've decided to change up the intro, which you guys have probably noticed by now. So I hope that you guys like the intro as much as we do. We felt that it would definitely suit our style a little bit better, and you guys will now not have to watch an intro that is a minute long every time we post some content. So I think it'll be a nice happy medium here for the both of us. But without further ado, guys, we have a lot of things to talk about here. So we're going to be essentially talking about if the golf pass here for season 30 is really worth buying. So we're going to be opening all of the chests here that we can get throughout the season 29 golf pass to really see if the gems that we're getting in the cards are really worth replacing the pin chest, in my opinion. Now we're going to be talking about some more controversial topics, so if you guys would like to let us know your thoughts and opinions on the things that we're talking about here today within the video down in the comment section below, definitely feel free, because we would love to see what your guys' opinions and thoughts are on some of these issues and what some of the fixes may be in your eyes. So definitely feel free to do that. And if you guys have not already hit that like button, definitely smash that like button for us, guys, and subscribe to the channel. Join our amazing community of golfers and gamers. We are expanding every day and would definitely love to have you as a part of the Team Energy family. So definitely click that subscribe button. But let's jump on over to the video and get started. All right, guys, welcome to the video here today. So we have a lot of information here to cover, so I hope that you guys can bear with me here as we go through this together. So we're going to start essentially by picking apart this golf pass and really seeing what they have to offer, and then we're going to jump to show you guys some more of the numbers and the actual statistics and open all of these reward chests that we have throughout season 29 to really compare that to this season 30's golf pass and if those numbers are going to stay consistent throughout these golf passes that we're going to get within the future, and if it's going to be a good, valid replacement for the pin chest. Now, I know that there is a lot of different factors that play into this, so we're going to be basically diving in and talking about all of that stuff individually as we go throughout the video. So if there's something that you're looking for in specific, we will definitely try to put some timestamps down in the description below after the video is uploaded. But so far throughout this season 30, I have noticed that they have offered one chest less than they did last season, but also noting that they have revamped these chests as well. So now they won't be the exact same chests that we're getting throughout the entire golf pass as we were previously. Previously, we were just getting the season chests. Now we're getting these mega season chests, the giant season chests, and etc. So they offered 13 of these reward chests this season, and last season they offered 14 of these reward chests. Now we're going to open all of these chests here and basically show you guys all of the gems that you could potentially get from this golf pass to compare that to how many days that we would have had within that month previously to potentially finish and complete our pin chest to those potential gems that we could have got from the pin chest instead. So let's jump on over here and start opening these chests, guys, and really dive into all these gems, coins, and items here for club cards that we're gonna get throughout this golf pass from at least these reward chests. All right, guys, so diving in to our very first chest here that we're going to open from season 29. This is our very first reward chest that we get at tier 3. So we got 32 gems there right off the bat. Now, that does not, in my opinion, I do not think that the division perk has anything to do with the amount of gems that you are going to get throughout these this golf pass and these chests. Now, the different chests will definitely give you varying gems. Now, the blue season chests, in my opinion, those are going to kind of resemble a gold chest, and the crimson mega chests are going to be kind of like a platinum chest, and the giant season chest being more like a king's chest or something like that. It's going to be essentially around the same type of system that you're going to see as the chests go up higher. You're going to get better items and more gems, more coins, obviously. So we're going to actually talk more about those factors that it's going to take to get those season tokens to be able to unlock all of the tiers in the golf pass. But before we jump on over and do that, we're going to give you guys just a little bit of math here that we have calculated. So comparing our old pin chest, we would have gotten roughly around 840 gems on average per season. Now that's roughly 30 gems per day from our pin chest at times those 28 days. Now that could be varying depending on the month. Some months we have 31 days, so that would obviously make the amount just a little bit higher there, more equaling out towards 900 or a little bit above. But with this new golf pass as well, we are able to obtain a rough average at about 907 gems. So if we can obtain every single one of the reward chests, we would roughly average out at about 907 gems. So I know that that's going to essentially vary just a little bit from month to month, but it's going to give us at least a good visual on how to compare this golf pass. Now, with this new golf pass, that's actually giving us more gems than we would have gotten before with our pin chest, which I was actually very surprised about. I figured that it would be a little bit less than we would have been able to get from the pin chest. But if you do add up those other days from months that are like 31 days out of a month, it would actually potentially be more than 907 or 913. Like I got on one of my tallies from one of my accounts, I got 913 gems. And on one of my other accounts, I got 902 gems. So that's where I came up with the essential happy medium there at 907. So that's going to basically leave us at, saying that it's pretty similar as far as the golf pass and the pin chest, as far as their comparison and them being, you know, a good fit really to replace the pin chest, because you can still get the same amount of gems over time that you would have gotten in that full month regardless. Now, we wouldn't get them every single day particularly, but if we keep playing and keep on that, we'll definitely be able to knock down those tiers and get throughout the golf pass to unlock those. But that's going to lead us to also talking about here, the tier system is kind of working against those players that have, that don't have the golf pass, because essentially those players that do have the golf pass and are able to complete those weekly and season challenges are going to be able to collect on all of those other season tokens and challenges that those players that do not have the golf pass will be unable to collect on. So that's where, you know, the money comes in, and you're not essentially paying money for the gems, but you're paying money to be able to get those gems faster, in my opinion. So that's basically going to leave you guys with the question of whether or not you want to pay for things to be just a little bit easier and be able to unlock those challenges, or pay the $19.99 and get half of it done already, so that you only have to do half of it and you can buy the first half. Or you play a little bit harder and not buy the golf pass to make up for not being able to collect on those weekly and season challenges. You play a little bit harder, or you just spend that little bit of money to make it easier for you to get those gems and, you know, the club cards and be able to collect on all of those things so that you get it. That's completely up to you guys. But we're just going through here essentially showing you guys all of these rewards that we're getting throughout the golf pass that could potentially make it worth buying or not worth buying. But nonetheless, we just want to get the information out there to you guys so that you guys are knowing what to expect really when you're buying golf pass, and you guys can do with this information as you please. But we're at least trying to show you guys what's going to be in these reward chests and what kind of club cards and balls and, you know, multiples and amounts of club cards that you're going to be expecting to get around the division bonus that we're opening these chests at. So definitely do keep that in mind, that we are going to get varying gems as well, and we will always get varying amounts of club cards depending on our division perk. So we've actually been able to get quite a few good items out of these chests, I definitely do want to say. I will give them that, because we have been able to get, you know, balls like we have been before, like we would have out of our pin chest. We're still getting decent balls and a good amount of them as well. Like you just saw in that chest, we got a Marlin there, a Navigator, and a Kingmaker there, I believe. So we're definitely getting some pretty good items still, and we're being able to get more items and better items, in my opinion, as these chests go on. And now that they have revamped these chests, the season chests, like we talked about, in my opinion, will probably give the least amount. So if you have 100% at least division bonus, you know, you'll be getting as close to you know, what you should be expecting out of those chests at 100%. And if you're above 100%, obviously you're going to be expecting to get just that little bit more, as you have that little bit of a bonus there with it as well. But that is essentially going to leave us over to the question of whether or not really the golf pass is just worth buying off of just these reward chests. Now, if it was just for the reward chests and we were only getting these chests from buying the golf pass, I would be kind of up in the air about it to see whether or not it would actually be completely worth it or not. But as they have offered these new tees and hole explosions as well, I would wager to say that with all of the items plus all of the gems and the balls and the things that we're getting between all of these different chests and the things they're offering, I would definitely say that the golf pass is worth buying. Now, that's going to essentially be for the player out there that really wants to, you know, try to get through this golf pass and unlock all of these things as fast as they can, so that they get the maximum rewards and things that they can out of the golf pass and are willing to spend money. But on the other hand, I would also wager to say that the golf pass just by itself is a good addition for a lot of the free-to-play members as well that really aren't wanting to spend money on the game, that if they don't really need the tees and the hole explosions, you know, eventually that may hinder you as you get up through, you know, the tiers and divisions, because you may struggle competing with some of the other crowd if you're lacking balls and things like that. But, you know, that's going to be something that you'll have to face later on and determine yourself whether or not that's something you want to do, if you want to spend a little bit of money to try to up your game a little bit, because it definitely will help a little bit, because that's kind of how they have, you know, managed to create this system. But as far as just the free-to-play version and being able to unlock a lot of these free things they do have, I think that they've offered quite a bit of items that would make just the general golf pass worth going through and actually trying to complete. So, you know, if you're really wanting to do that and not spend money, then that's more power to you. That's 100% fine. And I think that they have offered quite a bit of, good things for those people. But if you're willing to spend that little bit of extra money that you have, if you do have some, to, you know, buy the golf pass and be able to up your game in a particular season, it would definitely be worth doing that as well. But as far as doing it every single season, that's going to be something that you're going to have to judge how much you think that you may play this season, or, you know, if you're not thinking you're going to play as much this season, you know, I would hold off on buying the golf pass, and then, you know, you can always buy it a little bit later if you complete some challenges and you want to collect on some of those things and you think that you could complete it. That's why it's always there. Which, that leads us over to something else that I wanted to talk about as well, with the notification system, because I definitely think that Playdemic needs to either make all of the challenges available to everybody so that there is, everybody can collect on all of the notifications, and then you don't have to just buy the golf pass to get rid of those notifications and be able to collect on a lot of those seasonal and weekly challenges that, in other words, if you didn't have the golf pass, you wouldn't be able to collect on. So I definitely think that's one issue that Playdemic needs to address and maybe fix a little bit, or, you know, at least come up with some type of better solution so that we can all be able to do these challenges, and maybe, you know, play with the challenges and give us more challenges that we could actually flip through and be able to determine which challenges we wanted to do, and which ones, you know, we wanted to hold off on maybe a little bit and just, you know, work on, or, you know, easier ones that we could, you know, do a little bit faster that we could switch through and be able to complete and still get like 20 or 30 tokens here and there throughout the day. I definitely think that that would give people a little bit more ambition to want to complete some of these challenges throughout the tours and things like that, because that's really what we're trying to do here, is incorporate all of those challenges to in-game aspects while playing the tours and tournaments and things like that. Which leads us over to another thing that I wanted to talk about, which is I would really like to see them start doing some type of challenges within the tournaments as well. Now, I'm not talking anything too crazy here, but it would be nice to see them do some type of aspect where you have a challenge that's, say, 120 season tokens that allows us to make an eagle chip within the weekend round of the Christmas Parks tournament. And, you know, that's only going to allow a certain percentage of people that do really make it into the weekend round. So that's already only going to be a certain percent of people that are going to be able to have the potential to complete that challenge. And then you'll have those certain few that do get extra strokes or, you know, land that eagle chip and are actually able to complete the challenge. So you'll have things like that, and maybe those things will complicate those issues, and that's maybe why they don't have those challenges. But at the same time, if the percentages are right and those things would be comparable to do and actually be able to incorporate those, I think it would be a pretty cool idea to throw around some tournament ideas as far as these challenges and these tournaments go. So it's just definitely one thing to think about there. As we go through the very last part of this golf pass though, guys, we just essentially wanted to show you guys a good video on what the golf pass really has to offer and how it does compare to the pin chest, and if it is a good fit to replace the pin chest or not. Show you guys really what you're expecting when you're buying the golf pass, because obviously those things that you can see like the tees and the practice tokens, the hole explosions. That's all the stuff that you can see, that you are aware that you are getting when you buy the golf pass. But opening all of these chests and stuff like that, you're really not, fully aware of about, roughly how many, gems am I going to get around the last chest, or, about halfway through the tier at tier 20 or, 18, how many gems might I get from that chest? You can go through here and look and basically compare, and hopefully it'll give us a nice increment, as to, what we're supposed to be expecting roughly about each season. So if we can expect to, get at least around 900-ish gems a season, that's going to essentially be able to still replace our pin chest in a good space, and be able to still, everybody that's free to play, be able to obtain all of those gems and rewards that we can get throughout that entire system, but at the same time offering a lot of those bonus tees and perks and all that kind of stuff for the guys that are willing and wanting to pay for it. So I definitely think that they have offered a good, amount for the paying player and for the free player. So that I will give them. But that is going to be the wrap-up for today's video, though, guys. I hope we were able to answer some of those questions out there that you guys had. So definitely feel free to reach out to us in the comment section below if there's any other questions that you guys might have about the golf pass and it potentially replacing the pin chest. And I hope this gave some of you guys out there a little bit more information to make you feel a little bit more comfortable with the golf pass replacing the pin chest. And maybe it gave you a little bit of insight on whether or not you may want to buy the golf pass or not. We're going to leave that up to you guys. But if you guys are still hanging out here with us today and you're watching the video, thank you guys very much for being here with us. It does mean so much to us that you guys are watching the video. And I want to let you guys know that we're making this video here on Christmas morning. So I also wanted to wish you guys a very, very Merry Christmas out there. And I hope you guys have an amazing holiday with your immediate family, if you guys are able to at least do that. But Merry Christmas, guys. Hope you guys have an absolutely outstanding rest of your holiday. And if you guys have not already, click that subscribe button down there. Click that subscribe button. Join the Team Energy family. And we will definitely catch you guys in the next video. Thanks for hanging out. And as always, happy golfing, guys. And good luck out there. Peace.